What is quinine and what is quinine used for? Quinine is used alone or with other medications to treat malaria, a serious or life-threatening illness that is spread by mosquitoes in certain parts of the world. Quinine should not be used to prevent malaria. Quinine is in a class of medications called antimalarials. It works by killing the organisms that cause malaria. How to use quinine? Quinine comes as a capsule to take by mouth. It usually is taken with food 3 times a day, every 8 hours, for 3 to 7 days. Take quinine at around the same times every day. Follow the directions on your prescription label carefully, and ask your doctor or pharmacist to explain any part you do not understand. Take quinine exactly as directed. Do not take more or less of it or take it more often than prescribed by your doctor. Swallow the capsules whole, do not open, chew, or crush them. Quinine has a bitter taste. You should begin to feel better during the first 1 to 2 days of your treatment. Call your doctor if your symptoms do not improve or if they get worse. Also call your doctor if you have a fever soon after you finish your treatment. This could be a sign that you are experiencing a second episode of malaria. Take quinine until you finish the prescription, even if you feel better. If you stop taking quinine too soon or if you skip doses, your infection may not be completely treated and the organisms may become resistant to antimalarials. Other uses for this medicine. Quinine is also sometimes used to treat babesiosis, a serious or life-threatening illness that is transmitted from animals to humans by ticks. Talk to your doctor about the risks of using this medication for your condition. When to use quinine? Before taking quinine, tell your doctor and pharmacist if you are allergic to quinine, quinidine, mefloquine, lyrium, any other medications, or any of the ingredients in quinine capsules. Tell your doctor and pharmacist what other prescription and non-prescription medications, vitamins, nutritional supplements, and herbal products you are taking or plan to take. Be sure to mention any of the following: acetazolamide, diamox, aminophylline, anticoagulants, blood thinners, such as warfarin, coumadin, and heparin, antidepressants, mood elevators, such as dizipramine, certain antifungals such as fluconazole, diflucan, ketoconazole, nizoral, and itraconazole, sporinox, cholesterol-lowering medications such as atorvastatin, Lipitor, lovastatin, mevacor, simvastatin, zocor, sizapride, propulsid, dextromethorphan, a medication in many cough products, fluoroquinolone antibiotics such as ciprofloxacin, cipro, gadafloxacin, ticin, not available in the U.S. Levofloxacin, levaquin, lomafloxacin, maxiquin, moxifloxacin, avalox, norfloxacin, noroxin, ofloxacin, floxin, and sparfloxacin, zagum, not available in the U.S.
Macrolide antibiotics such as erythromycin, E.E.S.E.mycin, erythrocin, and trolleandamycin, not available in the U.S.
Medications for diabetes such as repaglinide, prandin, medications for high blood pressure, medications for irregular heartbeat such as amiodarone, porterone, pacerone, digoxin, lanoxin, disopyramide, norpace, dofetilide, ticosin, flecainide, tambocor, procainamide, proconbid, pronestol, quinidine, and sotalol, betapace, certain medications for seizures such as carbamazepine, tegretol, phenobarbital, luminol, sulfodin, and phenytoin, dilantin, medications for ulcers such as cimetidine, tagamet, mefloquine, lyrium, metoprolol, lopressor, topral XL, paclitaxel, abraxane, taxol, pimazide, ORAP, rifampin, rifidin, rimactane, certain selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, SSRIs, such as fluoxetine, Prozac, Seraphim, fluvoxamine, Luvix, and paroxetine, Paxil, sodium bicarbonate, tetracycline, and theophylline. Your doctor may need to change the doses of your medications or monitor you carefully for side effects. Many other medications may also interact with quinine, so be sure to tell your doctor about all the medications you are taking, even those that do not appear on this list. Do not take antacids that contain magnesium or aluminum, alternagel, amphogel, alucap, alutab, basalgel, davascon, malox, milk of magnesia, or mylanta, at the same time as you take quinine. Talk to your doctor or pharmacist about how long you should wait between taking this type of antacid and taking quinine. Tell your doctor if you or anyone in your family has or has ever had a prolonged QT interval, a rare heart problem that may cause fainting or irregular heartbeat, an abnormal electrocardiogram, ECG, a test that measures the electrical activity of the heart, and if you have or have ever had G6PD deficiency, an inherited blood disease, or if you have or have ever had myasthenia gravis, MG, condition that causes weakness of certain muscles, or optic neuritis, inflammation of the optic nerve that may cause sudden changes in vision. Also tell your doctor if you have ever had a serious reaction, especially a bleeding problem or problems with your blood after taking quinine in the past. Your doctor will probably tell you not to take quinine. Tell your doctor if you have or have ever had a slow or irregular heartbeat, low levels of potassium in your blood, or heart, kidney, or liver disease. Tell your doctor if you are pregnant, plan to become pregnant, or are breastfeeding. If you become pregnant while taking quinine, call your doctor. If you are having surgery, including dental surgery, tell the doctor or dentist that you are taking quinine. Tell your doctor if you use tobacco products. Cigarette smoking may decrease the effectiveness of this medication. What special dietary instructions should I follow? Unless your doctor tells you otherwise, continue your normal diet. What should I do if I forget a dose? Take the missed dose as soon as you remember it. However, if it has been more than 4 hours since the time you should have taken the missed dose, skip the missed dose and continue your regular dosing schedule. Do not take a double dose to make up for a missed one. What side effects can quinine cause? This medication may cause low blood sugar. You should know the symptoms of low blood sugar and what to do if you develop these symptoms. Quinine may cause side effects. Tell your doctor if any of these symptoms are severe or do not go away. Nausea. Restlessness. Difficulty hearing or ringing in the ears. Confusion. Nervousness. Some side effects can be serious. If you experience any of the following symptoms, call your doctor immediately. Rash. Hives. Itching. Flushing. Hoarseness. Difficulty breathing or swallowing. Swelling of the face, throat, lips, eyes, hands, feet, ankles or lower legs. Fever. Blisters. Stomach pain. Vomiting. Diarrhea. Blurriness or changes in color vision. Inability to hear or see. Faintness. Easy bruising. Purple, brown, or red spots on the skin. Unusual bleeding. Blood in the urine. Dark or tarry stools. Nosebleeds. Bleeding gums. Sore throat. Fast or irregular heartbeat. Chest pain. Weakness. Sweating. Dizziness. Quinine may cause other side effects. Call your doctor if you have any unusual problems while taking this medication.